Our universe is full of crazy, unexpected objects and events that make it such an amazing place to explore. So many of the discoveries made in space are unexpected. Some of them are incredibly interesting while being beautiful and benign. But there are others that are extremely violent and destructive. Astronomers' jobs are to study what happens in the cosmos and try to explain what is happening and to predict events happening in the future so that they can take a closer look. Whether these events have an impact on Earth or not, understanding them more will lead astronomers to a deeper understanding of our universe. Asteroid impacts. One of the first examples of a cosmic event that humans experience were asteroid impacts. Astronomers have found that our own solar system has a large asteroid belt within it. This belt sits between Jupiter and Mars and contains over 700,000 individual asteroids in the main section of the belt. If an asteroid were to be hurled from the belt in the direction of Earth, a large enough impact will cause a lot of change to life on our planet. Like when an asteroid impact brought the age of dinosaurs to an end. The damage from the impact would be enormous, but it wouldn't be the only form of disaster due to the asteroid. An impact big enough could send enough dust and soot into our atmosphere that the sun could be blackened out for years. If Earth is struck with an asteroid impact, we can all expect life on this planet to change drastically in its aftermath. Radio signals from deep space. Some discoveries that astronomers make have no simple answer as to what they are. The instruments that we use to learn about our universe give us data that has to be interpreted in order to ascertain what it is showing us. One type of information that gets transmitted throughout the galaxy are radio waves. Radio waves are a type of light wave that can travel vast distances through the vacuum of space and can be picked up by our instruments and can tell us a lot about what produced the signal and where it comes from. But sometimes, scientists cannot figure out the origin of a signal and need to test new theories to understand what is happening. Astronomers using telescopes like Hubble have discovered over 1,000 fast radio burst signals, FRBs, coming from deep space since the first discovery of one in 2001. These signals are extremely powerful pulses of radio waves that can last for only fractions of a second, and scientists still do not know what causes them. The majority of the signals that have been detected only came through once, but some signals have been known to be picked up again and again, most of the time without a recognizable pattern. However, a telescope in Canada has recently found a fast radio burst that repeats on a regular cycle that takes about 16 days. This type of repeating pattern intrigues astronomers because they believe that they can use the pattern to help understand what is producing these bursts. Strange signals from the Milky Way. These strange signals are not only coming from deep space. Astronomers have also found these signals coming from sources within our own galaxy. In 2020, two separate radio telescopes on the ground detected an extremely intense pulse of radio waves. These radio pulses were classified as FRBs. Scientists don't know what or how fast radio bursts are created, but they know it must have a high energy source. They were able to trace back these radio bursts from a general area in space that is only 30,000 light years from Earth. This makes this FRB the closest one to Earth ever discovered. Astronomers still do not know what produces these fast radio bursts, but some evidence has come out in recent years that point towards a few new theories. One of the most promising theories that came along the detection of FRBs from the Milky Way points towards young neutron stars being a possible source. Neutron stars are the remnants of massive stars that went supernova but did not condense their mass enough to form a black hole in the aftermath. But until they can get more data and better instruments, their origins will still be a mystery. Rogue planets. Ever since scientists began to probe outer space with high-powered rockets and telescopes, they have been looking for other signs of habitable planets. They look for planets that are close enough to their star to be warm, as well as other features that may sustain life. Although, astronomers have found a lot of planets that could be considered habitable. They have also found many more that do not fit the description. One type of planet that is definitely not hospitable are rogue planets. Astronomers have recently found planets that are not orbiting a star at all and are drifting through the cosmos on their own. The vast majority of planets astronomers have discovered are in orbit around a star. But these rogue planets have been ejected from the star system they were born in, destined to drift through the cold vacuum of space. No one knows what caused these planets to eject, but some theories posited included asteroid impacts with enough force to dislodge them from orbit. Another theory as to how rogue planets come about is that after their birth orbiting a star, another celestial body like a star comes close enough that its gravity pulls the planet out of its orbit and into space. Regardless of how they became rogue, once they are on their own, they will drift in the cold vacuum of space. Rogue black holes. The discovery of black holes changed the way we look at the universe. Knowing that there are massively dense objects out there with gravitational pulls so strong that not even light can escape. But as astronomers sought out more information about black holes, they made some discoveries that shocked them even more. They know that many galaxies have massive black holes in the center of them, and that smaller black holes are not extremely rare within the greater universe. But one discovery that they did not anticipate is that black holes do not always stay in place. Rogue black holes have been discovered flying through space at mind-boggling speeds. These monsters can fly through space devouring anything unlucky enough to be in its path. Astronomers believe that black holes can become rogue black holes after being ejected from whatever galaxy they were born in. This could happen as a result of two galaxies colliding with each other, flinging their contents into empty space. If a black hole gets ejected, the rogue black holes will barrel through space, and there isn't much that could stop it. Galactic cannibalism. Did you know that galaxies can eat each other? When two galaxies come close enough to each other, the larger galaxy's gravitational force will begin to draw the smaller one in. This will start the process of two galaxies merging into one, in an extremely violent event called galactic cannibalism, where two galaxies become one. Both galaxies will begin to accelerate towards each other, and as they begin to continue, they will begin spinning around each other while stars from both of them are ripped free and flung out into the cosmos. After the collision and settling, the two galaxies will have become one larger galaxy. Gamma ray bursts. There are all types of events throughout the galaxy that give off different types of energy. One of the most powerful types of energy that can be produced in our universe comes in the form of gamma ray bursts. Events that give these energetic bursts off are some of the most powerful and destructive events in our universe. They include supernovas, black holes, and a few other theoretical sources. When a star goes supernova, it generates a large blast of energy that is emitted as a gamma ray burst that spreads out from the star into space. Once the bursts are into space, they will travel at the speed of light until they run into something. If Earth is unlucky enough to be in the path of a strong gamma ray burst, we can expect to deal with some difficulties on our planet. A burst strong enough can knock out the electronics that control our satellites, as well as take out much of the electrical systems on Earth. The Sun will expand as it dies. One of the more dire discoveries for Earth that astronomers have made has to do with our own Sun. Our Sun is currently classified as a yellow dwarf star. It does not have enough mass to go supernova at the end of its life, but that doesn't mean it'll just go out. When our Sun begins to die, it will begin to slowly expand out until it becomes a red giant. When it expands, it'll get close enough to Earth that it will scorch the Earth, evaporating all of our surface water and killing much of the life here. It may even get so big that it engulfs the Earth as it expands. But don't worry, this is not going to happen for at least another 7 billion years, so we have time to make a plan for our escape. Planet made of ice is on fire. There are many planets out in the cosmos. Did you know that astronomers found a planet that is both made of solid ice and is burning at temperatures over 800 degrees Fahrenheit? It's called Galesse 436b and is a Neptune-sized planet discovered in 2004. Galesse 436b has the unique properties of having a surface made of solid ice while having surface temperatures above 800 degrees Fahrenheit. Astronomers believe that this is possible due to the immense gravity from the core of the planet, which causes the ice to be under so much pressure that it cannot melt. The surface is also covered in a layer of hydrogen and helium gas, which acts as another insulator keeping the balance between fire and ice. Dark matter. Everything that humans have ever seen makes up only about 15% of the matter that makes up our universe. Scientists have named the other 85% dark matter because it does not interact with light, making it invisible to our eyes, and does not interact with ordinary matter outside of its gravitational pull. Astronomers know that dark matter is out there because its gravitational effects can be seen throughout the universe, affecting giant clusters with its gravitational pull. While they don't know what dark matter is, there is no shortage of theories taking a shot at the answer. Dark matter has been theorized to be made up of dark bosons, which form invisible ghost stars that float throughout space, not interacting with any matter that it touches. Another theory states that dark matter could be made up of trillions upon trillions of subatomic particles that are just too small for us to see, like neutrinos. But until scientists know what dark matter is, they will have to keep observing its effects and trying to study it more. There are so many fascinating things to discover in our universe, and astronomers keep finding new objects and events that keep giving them a deeper understanding of the universe we all live in. We want to say thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please feel free to hit the like and subscribe buttons so you won't miss any of our future videos.